Okay, so this video is going to be about how to replace your coolant fluid and do a flush. So right here I have my 2001 Sprint RS, and as you can see, I already have my front fairing and side fairings out. So you can take those out super easy. Basically, it's just a couple of screws, and once you unscrew it, take it out from the rubber grommet over here and over here. And in the front, there's 5 screws securing the front fairing, which is super easy to take out as well. And for the side fairing, you have to be careful because it's connected to the top part of the fairing. And it has one extra screw over here that's holding it. You have to take your headlight out before you can take the side fairing out. So the headlight is also a little bit tricky because it's secured by like a couple bolts over here. You have to unscrew those to take the headlight out, and then you can take this screw out, which is securing it over there for your side fairing, and then lastly this screw, so you can take the fairing out from this part. Okay, once the fairing's out, it's obvious that the radiator axis is right over here in front, and this is your bleed screw. When you're refilling the fluid, you have to make sure the bleed screw is unscrewed and taken out so the water fluid can go in. Otherwise, it's a vacuum, so the fluid will just stuck over there, okay? And over here on the side is your reservoir for the coolant fluid. On the top is actually the drain tube for your reservoir, and on the bottom is the drain tube for your coolant, which is this tube over here. So when the fluid is flowing, it gets to this point, and all the extra fluid comes here and then goes into your reservoir. And my reservoir is actually pretty messy and nasty because the previous owner didn't do a good job of keeping the coolant replaced. So it's actually full of rust. This is after I washed it for like 3 times. And this fluid is what is coming out from my coolant. Right now I'm doing a flush. I'm using a mixture of 50% white vinegar and 50% distilled water. Make sure you use distilled water and not tap water for your radiator, otherwise you can get a lot of rust, okay? And of course the hard water have the calcium deposit, so it's gonna block a whole bunch of stuff in your radiator. Okay, so my vinegar solution is probably kind of cooled down a little bit, so it's ready to drain my first system flush. And once I flush this for the first time, I'm gonna do a second time run with probably just distilled water to fill the whole thing and then do a complete drain. And after that, I'm gonna fill my actual coolant right over there into the radiator. So now I'm just gonna drain all the vinegar solution out first. This is the first round. Okay, so of course I'm gonna loosen my bleed screw just a little bit. Okay, and right now if you want to touch your radiators, it's still pretty hot, so be careful when you open the drain bolt right over here. It might be hot water coming out. Okay, so I'm gonna try to get really far away as possible and just open my drain bolt. And right now I'm not loosening my radiator cap, it's still locked, so I don't suspect a lot of fluid coming out. And once I unlock it completely, well, you can see it's really nasty inside. Okay, so let's see how much water comes out. Not much. Okay. That's because the bleed screw is in and the cap is in. So I'm gonna unlock the cap a little bit, and it's probably gonna have some water coming out. Oh, yep, shooting out. And catch it over here, and I'm gonna get all the vinegar out. All right, completely out should be. So just took my cap off, and as you can see, it's pretty rusty in my engine. Coolant system. So I'm gonna do a second flush just to get all the nasty stuff out. Hopefully the second flush will come out cleaner than the first one. And as you can see, it's really easy. I didn't even lose my drain bolt for draining, but to be properly filling the radiator, you have to loosen the drain bolt completely. Okay, just gonna let it drain. It's gonna drain for a little bit. Okay. Move my pen closer as it starts to finish draining. Yeah, it's pretty nasty. I might even need to do a third round for dissolving all the rust in the system. Even though I got this bike in pretty low mileage, its maintenance is questionable. Because I think the oil haven't been changed for years, so the next step, which I'm going to put up a video, is how to change the oil on the Sprint RS. Okay. So the first round is done. I'm putting some distilled water and see. Get the last flush out. Okay. Still have some stuff out. And I'm gonna flush the second time. Of course, if I drain bolt, I'm gonna close this hole. Wow, ooh, check that out. Super nasty. And this is the drain bolt for your radiator that I just mentioned. It comes from here. And it's filled with rust, pure rust. I'm gonna flush it away, so. By the way, I got this stand from Harbor Freight for less than $30. I think with coupon it was $26 or $27, and it fits perfect for the Sprint RS, and it's super easy to use. Okay, so if you are looking for a stand, a rear wheel stand, this is the best way to go for less than $30. And you should be able to do most of your maintenance with this, just this one stand. Okay. All right. Let me fill the hole, close the draining bolt, and I am gonna flush it again with my 50% vinegar and 50% vinegar. I'm sorry, 50% vinegar and 50% distilled water solution. Okay, gonna come back and update you a little bit. All right, to properly refill your radiator system, you have to open your drain bolt correctly. If you don't open it, the fluid is not going to come in. Okay, so now I'm just going to pour my second batch of about half of distilled water into the radiator. And I really like this radiator because it's really easy to service. It's just I wish the previous owner would have done a better job. Alright, I poured about half of the water. I'm gonna add some vinegar. And I got this vinegar and water from Walmart. Okay. It's almost full. Add some more water. And some more vinegar. I'm just alternating to make sure I get about half of a mix. Yep, almost full. And the next thing is actually very important. Once you finish filling it, you have to add some more. Alright. You have to close your drain bolt, I mean the bleed screw. If you don't close it and you start the engine, the pump is going to shoot all the water out from this hole, which is kind of funny but also not very good. And that was the first mistake I made. So make sure the bleed screw is completely closed. You don't have to shut it super tight for the flush, but make sure it's closed. Okay. And I'm gonna start my bike. Find my key first. As you can see, I just started my bike, and right now the temperature is 62 Celsius degrees. I'm gonna wait until it hits 100 and the fan comes on, and I'm gonna turn off the bike. You can facilitate by just loading the thermal just a little bit, and it gets the drum drop really quick. But I left this hose from the radiator kind of flowing because I knew there's a lot of rust around this area. I just want to get the rust out. So as the coolant pressure goes up and expands, all the fluid comes out from here. Now you can see it's a little bit clearer now. So that is a good sign, I guess. That was this first, right over here. Okay. Temperature's still rising. I wish I could get this hose out, but it's kind of affixed to the inside of the bike spring over there with the clip, so I was unable to take it out. So this is the only way I can flush this tube full of rust. And okay, don't forget to dump your reservoir of all the nasty stuff and wash it properly, because this hose, it actually goes to the bottom and sucks the stuff back in. If the level of the coolant is low in your radiator, so make sure that is clean as well. Degrees. It's a good time to enjoy the idle sound of the trunk 3-cylinder engine. It sounds just like a diesel machine. Alright, that's 98. Once it hits 100, you'll hear the fan comes on. And that's when I'm going to turn off the ignition. Okay? 5 seconds up to a minute. Once it stops, I let it rest for a good 15 to 20 minutes before I come back and retry the fluid again. Okay? So then we'll come back again and update.
Okay, this is second flush with vinegar and distilled water solution, 50-50%. I already have my drain bolt loosened, and because I didn't lose my cap, so no fluid is coming out. So I'm gonna lose my cap. Let's see, let the fluid out. And this time the fluid is actually much more clean. There's still a little bit of rust deposit around the edge. I think I'm just going to clean it with the tongue. Alright, it smells pretty vinegary. So I'm going to do one more time and just flush the whole system with distilled water. And then I'm going to fill the entire system with a pre-mixed coolant. Antifreeze, okay? I want to say it's, I think it's still a little bit dirty. So I don't know how many times I want to do this, but yeah, it's pretty dirty. We're gonna do it again, so I don't want to bore you guys with the steps. I'm just gonna turn off the video and do it. Okay, after probably 3 or 4 flush of the radiator later, I finally have some clear liquid coming out, so I added some coolant. And at this point, I'm just gonna add the coolant, refilled, and be done with it to complete this coolant replacement process for the Sprint RS. And as you can see over here, I have a whole gallon of used coolant that I used to flush. And also the vinegar and water solutions, I just dumped it somewhere in the yard because it's not hazardous waste. So, and those are the coolants which I have to dispose properly. At this point, I'm just adding some extra coolant, okay, to squish out some of the liquid that's still in the system. And then after a little bit, I'm just gonna close this hole and fill the coolant to the proper level, as well as get the get the reservoir installed as well. And now I'm pretty safe to say it's good to go. The system is hopefully have much less rust in it at this moment, and the new coolant is supposed to have some rust inhibitor beauty. So as long as you change your coolant at recommended interval, you should be good. But this machine, I'm pretty sure it's neglected, so it had a lot of rust. And from this point on, it should be good. And basically, that's how you change your coolant fluid. So at this point, okay, let me get all the, let me just close the drain hole. And I'm gonna add coolant for the last time to fill it to proper level, okay. Gonna tighten it, 10 millimeter bolt. And I'm just gonna hand tighten, not so tight, because you know, it's an aluminum frame, so you don't want anything to be super tight. Okay. All right. Make sure your air bleed hole is open before you fill the coolant in and top it off. Okay. So try to find a good angle. We you can use a funnel, it's probably more efficient. But I'm just gonna pour it directly. And from what I read, it uses about 2.4 liters of coolant. I don't have a way to measure it. I basically just fill it to the top. The focus is not focusing. I think we're almost there. Hand is getting tired. Oh, almost. And my coolant is almost gone as well. I'm just gonna squeeze all those bottles for a little bit. I mean, the tubings. Probably have some empty space over there. See? If I squeeze it, some air bubble comes out. I'm gonna add some more coolant after I squeeze all the pipes. One last time. Okay, add some more. And you know it's properly filled when you see the coolant comes out from the bleeding hole. That means it's properly filled. Now we just need to actually close the cap. Okay. Sorry for the blurry autofocus picture, but I just closed my cap and I'm gonna close my bleed hole. Don't lose your bleed screw. Okay. And the whole system should be properly filled. And after I tighten it, I'm gonna use my bolt and not too tight. Okay, turn on the bike. First, let me wash my hand for a little bit. Wash all the coolant off. Of course, close the cap. And I'm gonna wash a little more on the bike because of all the extra coolant that's flowing out. Good. And this one I'm gonna actually dump it into a container that's empty. Flush it one more time. I'm trying to wash off all the coolants because I have some cats roaming in the yard. I don't want them to lick on any of the coolants. Very toxic to the animals. Okay. Close and tighten the cap. And then we're gonna start the bike. Try to pull the clutch and press the start button. Start it up.
this will be my last warm-up before I complete the coolant exchange procedure. After I finish with everything, I'm going to start putting all the fairings back. The front fairings, the side fairings, of course first you have to install the screw and make sure it won't resist a little bit. And then put the headlight back on and tighten from the inside of here. And only around inside our seat. So the whole procedure is complete. And we should be having all the new fluid. Okay, I think I just forgot the important part. The drain box. I'm actually going to reattach it after this video. Just make sure you reattach it properly so all your excess fluid would have a place to go. And of course, when you attach it, just install the reservoir and tighten the screw back onto the screen. So now I need to add some extra coolant to make sure it's between minimum and max. Okay? We can put all the things back together, I mean all the fairings, and we complete a radiator flushing and fluid exchange. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comment section, and I'll be happy to answer to you guys. Otherwise, I hope you find this video helpful if you also own a Sprint IS, because I personally haven't found any useful videos for servicing in my life, and hopefully this will help you guys. Thank you so much, and take care.